Hi everyone, my name is Nodalga Zakira Binti Zainal. I'm from IPG Campus Ipoh. And today I want to tell you guys about one of the story in Al-Quran, which is the story about Prophet Yusuf. So, let's begin the story. A'udhu billahi minash-shaytan rajim. إِذْ قَالَ يُوسُفَ لِأَبِيهِ يَا أَبَاتِ إِنِّي رَأَيْتُ أَحَدَ عَشَرَ كَوْكَبًا وَالشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرَ رَأَيْتُهُمْ لِسَاجِدِينَ. When Prophet Yusuf was still a child, he dreamed of seeing 11 stars, the sun and the moon prostrate before him. He was so impressed by his dream. The next day, he told his father about his dream. Hearing this, Prophet Yaqub was so happy because he knew it was none ordinary dream. That is a sign that one day Prophet Yusuf will be a person honored by God and men. Nevertheless, Yusuf's brother was envious and envious. They felt that Prophet Yusuf was more loved than them. In addition to Prophet Yusuf, their younger brother named Benjamin was also hated because he was considered to get the same love as Prophet Yusuf. In a secret meeting, his envious brothers suggested throwing Prophet Yusuf into a well. Prophet Yusuf's brother asked for permission to invite Prophet Yusuf to play by the forest. At first, Prophet Yaqub was hesitant, but after being urged by his children, finally, Prophet Yaqub agreed by giving them a message to be careful and to a good care of his younger brother. Arriving at the place, they told Prophet Yusuf to immediately take off his clothes. Without protesting, Prophet Yusuf has just followed his brother's words and they threw him in the well without paying attention to the cries of Prophet Yusuf. After returning home, they pretend to cry and told Prophet Yaqub that Prophet Yusuf had been beaten by wolves. Hearing what his children said earlier made Prophet Yaqub shed tears. A group of travelers come. One of them is taking water. He lowered the bucket, felt was heavy. They saw a boy and rescued him and hid him as a trade item. Finally, they agree to sell Prophet Yusuf to one of the ministers in Egypt named Kifti al-Aziz. They sell it at a cheap price. Kifti bought Prophet Yusuf to help his wife Zulaika in managing her household. Prophet Yusuf worked well, efficiently and honestly for many years. After Prophet Yusuf grew up, he was brave and handsome. He would have thought Zulaika had hope and fell in love with Prophet Yusuf because of his personality and Prophet Yusuf's dexterity in work. When Zulaika's husband, Kiftir, went abroad, Zulaika called Prophet Yusuf to her home. He tried to seduce Prophet Yusuf, but Prophet Yusuf refused and ran out the room. Zulaika pulled Prophet Yusuf's shirt from behind. When Prophet Yusuf opened the door of the room, suddenly, Kifti appeared. Zulaika felt anxious and scared. To defend herself, Zulaika accused Prophet Yusuf of doing bad things to her. Yusuf was very surprised to hear the accusation. He tries to explain to Kifter that he is innocent. Hearing the two confessions, which is from Zulaika and from Yusuf, Kifter becomes confused about who to believe. Because of that, he asked Zulaika's brother, who was known to be the honest and wise person. Zulaika's brother said, if the shirt worn by Prophet Yusuf is torn in the front, your wife is telling the truth. However, if Prophet Yusuf's shirt is torn in the back, it is Yusuf who speaks the truth. Khifti looked at the Prophet Yusuf and found that Prophet Yusuf's shirt was torn in the back. That means his wife is lying. This made him very disappointed in his wife. Khifti told Prophet Yusuf not to tell everyone and asked his wife to ask for forgiveness. After the event, Khifti's heart became restless. He realized that his wife was guilty. But in order to protect his good name, he imprisoned Prophet Yusuf so that Prophet Yusuf would be found guilty in court. Yusuf was patient and prayed to God to give him strength. He was appointed as a prophet by God after receiving several tests and being given miracles. One of them is being able to interpret dreams. Prophet Yusuf preached to the prison inmate. Among them, there were two court officials of the king of Egypt who were imprisoned on charge of opposing the king. They tell the dream they experienced. Fast forward the story, Zuleika has now realized her guilty, and then Allah put the love into Prophet Yusuf's heart towards Zuleika. They happily married. Moral of the story, people believe Yusuf because he tells the truth. Allah give Zuleika the good thing because Zuleika realized the guilty, and then Allah give love into Yusuf's heart because Zuleika is really realized and don't want to do that again. So because of Yusuf's behavior, peace has been making. Thank you. Bye bye.